Alright, before we start today's video, I want to go over two things with you guys quick. One is going to be if you are not entered into our Alola's Finest Episode 3 Shiny Prime Arena Team giveaway, you still have time. To enter, all you have to do is A, drop a like on this video or any other Wi-Fi Battle / Alola's Finest Episodes, B, subscribe to this YouTube channel, and C, comment anything in the comment section below. You do all these and you will be entered for a chance to win our Shiny Prime Arena Team. Winners will be picked in tomorrow's brand new episode of Alola's Finest, so spread word and don't miss out. And number two is going to be if you are not yet subscribed to our YouTube channel, I strongly suggest you do if you want to keep up to date with the channel. And if you are subscribed to our channel, do us a favor by hitting the bell button next to the subscribe button. That way you are notified of when we upload. It will be much appreciated. That's all I have for you guys today, and don't forget to leave a like, comment, and subscription down below, and enjoy. Yo, what is going on, guys? It is your boy Cipher today, bringing you guys another live Pokemon Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire. Today, I'm bringing you guys another live Pokemon Sun and Moon Wi-Fi battle. I do not know where that came from, but today we're gonna be battling my boy Chad, aka TickleMeChad, aka the Clown, aka pretty cool friend of mine. So definitely go check him out. I'll leave his Twitter link and YouTube link in the description below. My man's almost a 4K sub, so hopefully we can get him there. Hopefully you guys from the block party can get him there. But today we're gonna be battling him in the in an OU battle, if that's what you want to say. Where this is gonna be the last time we're gonna be using the same team from our Alola's Finest giveaway. If you do not know what Alola's Finest is what we do is we build a team on Showdown for one episode, and then for the next three Wi-Fi battles we use that team, and hopefully we can go positive, and we basically give that team to three lucky viewers and subscribers. So if you guys want to enter for that and you want to participate in Alola's Finest, if definitely a hit that like button for me, as it's greatly appreciated. The YouTube algorithm has changed, they're asking for likes, so I'm gonna ask you guys for likes, so hopefully we can kind of get that sorted if you guys help me out with likes. And plus it gets you one step closer to entering for to win this exact team that we're going to use. I'll show you in a second. So all you have to do is A, hit this like button, B, hit the subscribe button to this YouTube channel, and C, comment anything in the comment section below. You do that and you are entered for Alola's Finest. So like I said, I'm going to go ahead and show you guys the team that I'm working with today. So today, as you guys can see on your screen, we have Prime Arena, the shiny Prime Arena, I should say, that we built around, who is aka our Starbucks, holding the Waterium Z, because I kind of messed that up. It was supposed to give it the Premium Z, but I forgot you have to have its like signature moved in order to do that. So I just gave it the Waterium Z with Hydro Pump, so it's going to hit hard all, most of the time. So next we do have Kodak Whack, our nice and powerful Alolan Marowak, basically just going to be using that Lightning Rod ability to kind of soak up electric hits from our Prime Marine here. Next, we do have Queen Roach, our Pheromos, who is going to be our Choice Scarf Mon this week, so we can Choice Scarf U-turn on a lot of things that will hit hard. Next, we do have Baby Snoots, our nice and powerful Mamoswine, so hopefully we can get him to work a little bit. He's a Lead Sash Mamoswine. Next, we do have our Drampa, aka D-O-Double-G, and last but not least, we do have Math and Chill, our Porygon 2. So that's going to be the squad that I'm going to be running in with. So like I said, if you guys are hyped for today's battle and you want to see more Pokemon content, then definitely hit that thumbs up for me. Show some love on that like button, it'd be greatly appreciated. I'm gonna go ahead and click yes because I don't want to keep my boy Chad wait. So Chad, if you are watching this, my buddy, good luck to you, good luck to you, baby. And I'm gonna go ahead and pick some music real quick, and I'm just gonna pick my friend How. No, I'm gonna pick Gladion. I just love the Gladion music, I don't know why. So I'm gonna go ahead and pick Let the Battle Begin, and we're gonna do some battle shenanigans. We're gonna take a picture of his team real quick. So he has a crazy hella good team. So today on your screen, as you guys can see, he has an Alolan Exeggutor, an Alolan Marowak, a Guzzlord, a Guzzlord, a Cum Guzzler, whatever you want to say, I don't know. Next, he is a Porygon 2 as well. Next, he does in fact have a Magearna, and he has a Wishiwashi, so a pretty decent squad. So let's go ahead and assess some threats real quick. So Guzzlord could be a definitely big threat just because we don't have, I guess we have Prime Arena that could kind of wall that thing out a little bit. Porygon 2 for them is going to be a little bit of a challenge, but I don't see anything that can set up Stealth Rocks in his case, which is actually pretty good for us. So I think I'm just going to go ahead and lead off with my Baby Snoots, just because my Baby Snoots does put up the best work against this thing. And we can kind of go from there. We do need to keep Baby Snoots alive, because if we can get off the Ice Shard onto that Alolan Exeggutor, that's gonna be pretty dope. Like I said, good luck to my boy Chad. Definitely go check him out. Like I said, my man's almost a 4K subscribers, which I'm not even near 1K yet. So, well, I'm kind of close to 1K. If we can get to 1K pretty soon, that'd be pretty dope. So, anyways, Pokemon Trainer Chad, my boy Chad, TickleMeChad. So he's gonna leave with Porygon 2. Sorry, Chad, you sly dog, you sly dog. So he's going to be the download variant, so okay, so that's not horrible at all, actually. I kind of want to switch out, to be honest, and I kind of want to go into... kind of want to go to my own Porygon, but at the same time, I kind of don't. Let's see, this thing can't T-Wave me. It can try attack me. I don't think this thing has too much to hit me with, because he doesn't get Will-O-Wisp, so that's alright. So I think I'm just going to go for the Stealth Rocks, to be honest. As we are going to get the Stealth Rocks off, I'm kind of curious what this thing wants to be honest. As he is going to go for a Trick Room. Okay, so not even bad. Not even bad. Okay, so this is probably going to be a Trick Room Magearna team. I need to be careful about that, because that team was, like, hella crazy good against me. So, let's see. What can we really go for? We could go for an Earthquake and do a lot of damage to everything, but at the same time, he could probably just stay in. So, I'm going to go for an Earthquake and see how much damage this is going to do. He's probably going to go for a Tri-Attack here. With the plus one special attack boost, that's going to be pretty hard for us to hurt. Virus EXE. So he's going to go for the Ice Beam here. I do not have Thick Fat, so this should do a decent amount of damage, which kind of sucks. So we're going to get the Earthquake off, and that's going to do... it's going to do a decent amount of damage, about a good quarter. So I need to preserve this guy. I should have kind of kept that my Focus Sash intact, but there's not much I can do about it. What's Porygon's base speed? Porygon 2's base speed is 60, so I don't want to switch into Drampa just yet, because Drampa can't really do much, so... I'm going to switch to my own Porygon here, to be honest. I'm going to switch to my own Porygon 2 here. I don't know if this Ice Beam will do too much to us. I'm not too positive. I guess I could have switched into Alolan Marowak, too. Okay, my attack's going to rise. Okay, not bad, I guess. So this Ice Beam's going to do a decent chunk. Not too bad at all, actually. Here, I'm just going to go for the Tri-Attack. I don't see why not, to be honest. I have no speed investment. He probably has a negative speed nature for the Trick Room, so I guarantee he's probably going to outspeed us. He could go into his Alolan Marowak himself predicting the Tri-Attack. I'm not too positive. Chad is a slick, slick guy. I like the team, though, because I've never faced off against a Guzzlord, actually, which is going to be a little bit of a challenge. But we do have Primarina in the back. What's Guzzlord's speed, actually? I'm kind of curious. I'm actually kind of curious about that. Guzzlord... Oh, okay. Now we can type it. So Guzzlord is a base 43 speed, so that means Primarina is definitely going to outspeed that thing. He has a slow team that works well in the Trick Room, because he can actually set up Trick Room with his... I think Magearna sets up Trick Room, I believe Porygon sets up Trick Room, and I believe Alolan Exeggutor can set up Trick Room. I know the previous gen Exeggutor can set up Trick Room. Which is going to be fine, because once we can kill his, he's probably going to go into Marowak. Magearna, okay, so not bad at all, actually, not bad. If we can get a burn on this, then that'd be pretty nice. No, we don't get any status infliction. I just feel like our status infliction is, like, never going to happen. Okay, so the Trick Room is still up, unfortunately. I kind of want to go into my Kodak Whack, to be honest, because I can resist a Fluoro Cannon and plus a Flash Cannon. So I think I'm going to go into my Alolan Marowak to resist a Fluoro Cannon. And plus, he doesn't have any special attack raise right now, so that's actually kind of good. So I'm going to go into my Alolan Marowak right now. As he's going to Calm Mind here. Okay. Not good at all. Hopefully, I think this... I don't know if the Trick Room ends here. I think the Trick Room does end, though. No, the Trick Room does not end. What the hell? Oh, yeah, it does. Yeah, it does. Yeah, it does. Yeah, it does. Okay, perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. So I could Flare Blitz here. What is Flare Blitz going to obviously hit? Or I could Earthquake. I think I want to go for the Flare Blitz, though. Yeah, I'm going to go for the Flare Blitz just in case. He's not going to outspeed, that's for sure. Plus, we have Thick Club, so that means our damage is going to be doubled. Our attack should be doubled, actually, I should say. Because I know he's not going to stay in here. I feel like he's going to actually switch into either Wishiwashi or the Porygon 2. Or even the Guzzlord if he wants to. Guzzlord could actually be a good switch too. So he's going to withdraw. Pretty good play. Come Guzzler. I'm actually pretty surprised you actually got away with that one on Wi-Fi, to be honest. Either way, he's going to take a decent amount of damage. We're going to go for the Flare Blitz here. That's fine, actually. What's this thing? Defense stat. He eats that up really well. Eats that up pretty well. Oh, I forgot he's a super high. He has a super high defensive stat. So, since he's a dark type, I'm actually going to switch out of here. What does this thing get? Can this thing get Thunderbolt? Let's see if he gets any electric attack. He doesn't get any electric attacks, which is actually pretty well. What about poison? He does get poison jab, which wouldn't be bad in his part. I'm going to go into my Starbucks, actually. Yeah, I'm actually going to go into Starbucks here, and I'm actually just going to go for my my Water Z move. I don't see why not, to be honest. So we're going to switch into Primarina here. He's going to go for the Dark Pulse. This shouldn't do too much to us at all, as it doesn't. It does about a good almost quarter, I should say. So we do see this thing is Life Orb, though, which is actually not bad at all. And so here, I'm actually just going to go for my Water Z move. I see why not to go for the Water Z move, to be honest. He could switch into his Wishiwashi. Wishiwashi should take a decent amount of damage. If he does switch into Porygon, I think it will take out Porygon. It should do a decent chunk to the Magearna. And then I believe it should do a decent chunk to... It's going to obviously kill the Alola Marowak. But I think Exeggutor is probably the only one that will take it pretty well. So he's going to withdraw Cum Guzzler. Not bad. These Stealth Rocks are definitely adding pressure to him, which is actually pretty nice. So we're going to get off this Z move. Not bad at all. And then we should outspeed actually next turn for a Hydro Pump. So, man, if I had the Primarina Z on here, that'd be awesome. But I don't. Just haven't had time to switch like the actual like signature move of Primarina. So that kind of sucks, but it's whatever. It's not really that. It's not the end of the world, to be honest. Oh, perfect. That is what I needed, baby. That is what I needed. And now, I'm actually just going to go for a Moonblast. Or should I go for a Hydro Pump? I don't want to go for the Hydro Pump miss. I don't want to go for the Hydro Pump miss. But I feel like a Moonblast should take it out. What's Magearna's base speed? Magearna. Where are you, Magearna? Magearna has a base 115 special defense, so it's not horrible. I don't know, because I don't want to like mess up and not kill. Actually, and it resists. Alright, I'm just going to go for a Hydro Pump, YOLO. Alright, cool. We landed the Hydro Pump, thankfully. I did not want to, like, take... I had to take that risk because I didn't know if Moonblast would kill. I wasn't too positive. But either way, thankfully, Magearna is out of here. So, Primarina is definitely going to... It's putting in the work right now. So, that's... I'm pretty thankful for that one. So, now he's going to switch out into Virus EXE. Now, you could set up the Tricker potentially here, which is fine. It's definitely not the end of the world. So now that we have somewhat of damage, I'm gonna go for the Moonblast, and I'm hopefully gonna get the special attack lowered. If I get the special attack lowered, that'd be perfect. No, he's gonna go for the Trick Room here, and I could definitely see him setting up a the recover. So I'm just gonna keep going for the Moonblast and hopefully get the special attack lower. Hopefully we can get the special attack lowered. That'd be awesome. That'd be perfect. That'd be so nice. Let's see what happens with it. Moonblast, perfect. That's fine. We land. We good. We gravy. Special attack lower? No, what the hell? Oh my gosh. Kinda wanna go for a Hydro Pump. Nah, I'm not risking the biscuit. I can't believe actually that that Z move did that much to that thing. But if we can get the special attack lower, I'd be so grateful right now. Wow, three turns we haven't got it. But yeah, every other time I battle and I get it. That's fine. I'm just gonna keep going for a Moonblast. He is packing Thunderbolt, so that's fine. It's gonna do a shit ton of damage. Not bad. If we can get a special attack lower, that'd be pretty nice. Wow, four Moonblasts. We haven't gotten it. That's kind of crazy, actually. Now that I see he's going for Thunderbolts, I kind of want to go into my... Yeah, I'm actually going to switch into my Drampa. Because I don't have any speed investment in my Drampa, I believe. I might. Yeah, I'm 92 in speed. So he's going to recover here. Not bad at all. Not bad at all. Oh, but he's going to... Alright, well, now that he does not, in fact, have a fairy type right now, I feel like I'm pretty safe to go for a Draco Meteor. So, we are going to outspeed. We land the Draco Meteor. Not bad. Hopefully this will kill. I'm pretty sure this will kill. Huh? What? Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me right now? Are you absolutely kidding me right now? Okay, well that kind of sucked complete titty. That kind of sucked complete titty right now. What switch do I want to make though? I'm going to switch out here. I think I want to go into my Queen Roach. Yeah, I'm going to go into Queen Roach. Hopefully he doesn't go for an Ice Beam. I feel like he's going to go for another Recover, to be honest. And then if he goes for another Recover, then it's whatever. I figured the Recover was going to come. Alright, so now for him fearing a High Jump Kick, I feel like he's going to go into his Alolan Marowak. So with that being said, I'm actually just going to go for a U-turn, predicting the Alolan Marowak. He's going to switch out. He's going to go into Marowak, isn't he? Q-boner. Called it. I figured that was coming. So either way, we got the Marowak to take some damage. I figured that thing was going to come. So that was a good bait on our part. So now I'm going to go into my baby Snoots. I don't think Trick Room is up right now. I don't believe Trick Room is up. So, with that being said, I'm actually just going to go for an Earthquake. He's going to withdraw. Who's he going to go into? He's going to go into Virus.exe. That's fine. Not too really worried about it, to be honest. So, he's going to take Stealth Rock damage. And now, he is going to get the Special Attack Raise. Not bad. So easily this Earthquake should do a decent amount of damage to this thing. That was a crit. Now what's doing more at this point? Do I need... I'm just kind of calling bluffs at this point. Like, do I need... I'm going for another Earthquake. Hopefully this kills. Come on, please kill. Get a high roll, please, for me. 1 HP again? Are you kidding me? Oh, wait a minute. I have Ice Shard. Oh, my... I'm just gonna, like, act like I'm emotionless right now. Oh, me. I don't know. He's probably gonna switch into Wishy Washy. Nope, he's gonna. I forgot the Stealth Rocks are up, so either way, he's screwed. Perfect, that's fine. So we take out this Trick Room setter. Perfect, not bad. Kind of curious who wants to go. He's probably gonna go into Wishy Washy. He's gonna go into Squad Goals. Mine's Squadron, that's funny. Alright, so he's gonna take a shit ton of damage from, well, not shit ton, but he's gonna take a lot of stealth rock damage, so that's fine, actually. So I need to switch out here, actually, and I need to switch into something that can kind of, like, take a hit from this thing. So I'm gonna go into Porygon 2. And now I just kind of need to stall out the, I need to kind of just stall out the Trick Room. Hydro Pump, he's gonna land this Hydro Pump. This actually might take out my Porygon 2. No, it's not. No, it is not. Oh, so he is Life Orb, though. So that's actually pretty nice. Oh. Oh. Oh, Wishy-Washy's about to put in the finest. Hmm. Alright, well, we're gonna have to switch in Drampa. Oh, we're gonna have to switch in Drampa. Yo, I don't like this. I don't like this. Alright, I'm gonna make the switch into my Kodak Whack. Predicting the Ice Beam to come. Ice Beam's coming. That's fine. That's not gonna do much. I'm just trying to recall. I'm just trying to, like, get this damage up. Awesome. Perfect. And then now. Now I can switch into Drampa. Predicting the Scald. If I can predict the Scald to come, that's awesome. If he wants to switch, that's gonna be nice because he's gonna take more Stealth Rock damage. Oh, that was wrecking right there. Wishy-washy in the Trick Room is definitely something to watch out for. So we're gonna switch out here. This thing definitely doesn't get to Trick Room, I believe. But the good thing is here is now that I'm actually in range, he's gonna withdraw Squad Goals. Who's he gonna go into? He's actually gonna go into Cum Guzzler. Perfect. Perfect. And now, I'm just going to go for an Ice Beam. So we're going to get the Ice Beam off. Perfect. Nice. And that should take out Cum Guzzler, as it does. So it does take out the Guzzlord. Not bad, not bad. Now, unfortunately, with Faramosa is going to be pretty useless unless we go up against Alolan Marowak still. Because Magearn is dead, and... Oh my gosh, this sucks. This sucks. Chat's over tweeting at me. He's like, 1 HP again! Alright, so Alola Marowak's gonna take a lot of damage. That's fine. Drampa coming in clutch! And I'm just gonna Draco here. So we're gonna land the Draco. Perfect. Awesome. Not even bad. Good. Cool. Gold. Money. Cash. Low. Drampa is putting in work. You know what? This Pokemon is so good. I was sitting there, like, kind of avoiding it because I was like, it looks so bad, but, like, Drampa's a goddamn monster, dude. He's a monster. So he's going to go into his Alolan Exeggutor now. That's fine. We should outspeed, and I'm just going to go for an Ice Beam. Even though my special attack is lowered, I'm still Life Orbed, and this is 4 times effective, so it should take this guy out. As it does, dope money. Overcompensating. Oh my gosh, dude. This was like this is like a very OG squad build right here. I'm like so in love with this. Hopefully you guys participate in this, man, because I would love to give this squad out. So he's gonna go into Squad Goals now. That's fine. Who's gonna take a little bit of Stealth Rock damage? He's gonna go into Schooling here. I don't know if I want to switch. I think I want to switch out and go into Starbucks. Let's see. How many mon? Oh, yeah. This is last mon. Actually, I have Queen Roach to kind of take this thing on, so I'm just going to go for a Thunderbolt, actually. I have Queen Roach to definitely take this thing on and go for a lunge. So, either way, that was a GG to my boy Chad. And does it take it out? Oh, it doesn't! Oh, it doesn't! You're going to know if I used to be Mindy. Ah! I thought Thunderbolt was that. I thought it was going to kill. Oh, well. Either way, we can just switch into our nice and powerful Faramosa, and we can call that a game. Oh, actually, he just dies to this, to the life orb. So either way, like I said, that was definitely a good battle with my boy Chad. Like I said, go check him out. My man's almost 4,000 subscribers, so definitely go show him some love and such. And okay, I thought my audio for my 3DS went out. Anyways, like I said, if you guys enjoyed today's Wi-Fi battle, definitely show some love on that like button, as it's greatly appreciated. The new YouTube algorithm has changed. They're asking for likes, so I'm going to go ahead and ask for likes. And like I said, if you guys want to enter for Alola's Finest, this is going to be the last battle before we do pick the winners for next week. So like I said, if you guys want to enter to win this team, I'm going to be picking 3 lucky viewers as subscribers to win this exact same team that we used to trade over on Pokemon Sun and Moon. So like I said, all you have to do is A, hit that like button, B, subscribe to this channel, and C, comment anything in the comment section below. And with that being said, definitely go show my boy Chad some love in the description below. His YouTube and Twitter links are there, as well as my Twitch, Twitter, Instagram link. Go show some links there. And with that being said, I will catch you guys in the next video. So please have yourselves a great morning, night, evening, day, wherever you're at, and I'll talk to you guys later. Thank you for watching. What is cracking, cousin? See you.